H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Welcome back. I was a little late because of some issues on this GoToMeeting website. Like, it was crashing the software, so I need to restart the. I need to reinstall this GoToWebinar launcher. But this is good. We are starting now. Okay. Hello everyone. Few people are joining today only, I guess. Anybody here who is joining today as a first class? Can just type in the chat box. Okay, Sangeeta. Fine, not an issue. Great. So we are allowing just 1 minute for people who are yet to join. Awesome. And let me share my screen meanwhile. Just a minute. Let me know. Okay, I'm starting now. I want to show you something interesting today. Today we are not going to do any kind of, not going to discuss any kind of theory session. Okay, so today we'll actually do some Python stuff. Okay, real stuff. That is important because that will give you a good idea, like what exactly Python is, what's its importance. Okay, how it works. And I claimed that yesterday, right? I told you that Python is easy, but can I prove my point? So that's also introduction to real introduction to a Python programming. That's what we're gonna do today. Cool with that? So let's go to the website. And I'm just a minute. I'm trying to share. I don't know. Okay, hold on. Yeah, here you go. Is it visible? Are you able to see my screen now? Okay, great. Thank you. Okay, cool. So now your chat box is open in front of me. If you have any questions, stop me then and there. That's very important. And remember that if you stuck somewhere or if you want to know something in more details, you just have to bug me. Okay, I'll be here. Okay, so Python is basically published or provided by python.org. This is an official website of Python. And if you want to know about like how or why Python is important, you have to go for yesterday's video. And if you're not going through that, please go through it. Okay, it's very important because you should know why you are learning it. Now, Python basically provides a lot of documentation around its programming concepts. Whenever there is a new thing comes in, they will provide an extensive documentation on that. It's important, right? Plus, Python has a very strong open source community. Why this is important? Anybody know? Why open source community is very important? If you don't have a supporting community, suppose tomorrow I created my own language, let's say, okay? And I named that language as Rishi. Okay, so what will happen? Who are the users of those language? And I just taught you like how this language is awesome, but nobody uses that except me. Okay, or except me and except you probably. So you and me are using that language. Okay, so tomorrow you have a problem. Okay, you are facing a problem. Let's say date comparison, and now you want to search a solution online. Okay, what is a date comparison language? A date comparison program. In Rishi's language, do you get a solution? You will not get a solution. Why? Because nobody is using it. But if you do that with Python, I'm just search like, okay, Python date Compare is in and search, you'll get thousands of results, okay? And you can easily do the stuff. Getting my point, and you can get the program also now. So, right, date time, time delta, all those functions, and you'll get explanation of that. Why you're getting that? Because of very strong open source community, okay? So that's why whenever you are choosing a programming language for your enterprise, okay, whenever a company chooses a language, okay, for an enterprise, they look for this kind of stuff, whether a programming language has a stronger open source community or not, okay? Fortunately enough, Python has a number one open source community on a Salesforce, and people are contributing a lot, and you'll get, and not even this, date comparison on is very easy problems. Okay, let's think about a very complex one like Google car. Okay, well, Google car is a much complex problem to solve, right? It's based on Naive charts. Okay, so Naive Bates algorithm. Okay, and just say Naive Bates. Let's see how many you get. We're thinking about that. So see how much complexity people are already answering. Okay, that is very important for choosing any kind of language. So this is where you are. So now, how do you get Python on your computer? Very straightforward and simple thing. Now you have to go to python.org. Now if you want to go there right now, you can go or do that. Plus, but if you don't want to do it, okay, that's also fine. I'm going to tell you what is the alternative. Okay, so if you just want to test water, okay, you can just try something else also. Now you have to go to downloads, depending on your operating system, remember that. So you have Windows, Mac, other platforms also like Linux, Ubuntu, whichever you have. You can choose this download 3.9.5 or just choose here and it will start downloading Python on the machine. Hardly like 25 MB or something. Yeah, it's almost done. Yeah, here you go. So that's it. That is a Python installation. So, okay, and then you can start, click on this particular thing and then next, you will get it. Okay, not a big deal. And if you want me to run through this, real quick, okay, not more, because I will give you another way to use Python if you really don't want to install it. Okay, okay, so let's see that. Okay, meanwhile the algorithm starts, the program starts, we will actually learn about a new way, a better way to actually try your Python code. So the simplest website, okay, which is actually giving you a Python compiler and build, okay, so this is the one. This is already giving me that there is a Python already installed here. Can you, do you want to change it? So I say, okay, customize this installation. Okay, you'll get all these options. Click on next. Okay, I'm going to change the path. I'll just say 6. Okay, and I'll install. So it will install Python on that particular folder. Fine. Meanwhile, it installs. I will give you, this is straightforward, right? How many next button I have to click anyway? Okay. Now, are you all with me? Are you all with me? We are programming something today. Okay. Now you have to do this. You have to go for Python coding.com. Oops. Let me grab that. What's this? Python code or Python coding? Let's see. It's onlinepython.com. Okay, so that was a different thing. Onlinepython.com. Isn't that awesome? So let's go back and say online-python.com. So just simple. And here is the link for that. You can just say online-python.com. It gives you a straightforward compiler in on your Windows, on your browser, and you can literally write the code there. Isn't that easy? Free platform. Okay, so let me give you the link. All of you, did you get the link? Okay, amazing. Okay, and whatever code you have, can you send it to me? Absolutely, that is for you only, not for me, for you. Okay, the PPT is for you. I'll be sending it, don't worry. Okay, so now this is main.py. Just delete all this stuff, okay, and we're gonna start with our Python journey. We'll try to introduce ourselves to Python, and whatever I claim, right? Python is easy and all that. Okay, can I prove my claim? That's what we are here for. We'll do this. So let's try. Let's try different stories, different difference in Python. Are you all able to see this deck? Is it good? I'll just make the screen bigger. Okay, so what you have to do is open Python editor. Okay, go to this onlinepython.com, write the code, and click the run button. That's it. And what is the code? We are just going to print hello world. And writing hello world in Python is not 5 lines or 6 lines. People who are coming from Java background, C++ background, they know this stuff. Okay, just for printing hello world in Java, you have to write 6 lines of code, 6 lines. And in Python, you have to do this hello world. Okay, so let's come back here and let's start. So I'm gonna print, and you can do that with me. Print. Just so simple, like English. We have the same Python compiler that I want to say hello. Is that simple? And that will be hello world for me, and that will be my first code. So let's run this, and you'll get hello world here. Process expired. Return code is 0. That means successful, and you are done. Cool with that? How hard it is? How hard it is? Can you try? Can you try yourself? Absolutely right. Awesome, right? Is that simple? So this is our first statement. Okay, called hello world. Now hello world is not programming. Okay. Now just by knowing hello world doesn't mean that you know programming. Right? Definitely this is like a starting point. So let's take a next slide. Like what exactly is talking about? So let's go to it. So take an input from keyboard. Now my problem statement is changing. I'm making the stuff complicated for you. I'm making the stuff complicated for you, and we will explore more on Python up to reading a file. Think about that. Okay. So you're gonna read a file. Okay. So now taking an input from keyboard, can I do that? Can I do that? Can I take something from keyboard? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use input function. Okay, there is some function called input, and I will take your name, okay, and say hello to it. So say hello to yourself. How do you do that? So remember that. You remember when we learn mathematics, we use variables. All of you remember that? Like this is a triangle side A, triangle side B, and find the hypotenuse, that is x. Okay, so x square equals to a square plus b square. All the same, what is that x and a and b? All those things are variable, correct? So variable is what? Variable, the value of that varies, okay, depending on the situation, depending on the condition. Okay, understood that concept? So name equals to something, employee ID equals to something. Okay, name by name, store equals to Home Depot. Got it? So all these things are what? Variables. So similar to that, we're gonna store something into a variable. So that variable for us is name, okay, and we're going to use input function for that. We'll do this. So I'm saying name is my variable, and whatever you are going to enter through the keyboard, that value will be assigned to the variable. Okay, all of you up to this point. Okay, and here I'm going to use input function. You can do that with me. Input, and here in quotes, you say enter your name. How hard is that? Okay, so name is going to be an input, and there will be a cursor which is asking you enter your name. Got it? And now whatever comes in, okay, so whenever you are providing an input, what you will do, you will print it. Okay, don't worry, I'll explain that. So suppose, okay. First thing I explained is what is variable. Variable is a varying value. So whatever you are getting it from the keyboard, you have to do what? You have to store that somewhere. Yes or no? Whatever I'm giving it to you, you have to store that. If I send you a file, you will keep that in your files, okay? It in hard drive, right? Similarly, if I'm entering a value, you will keep that in some memory location. That memory location has a name. Okay, that name has, that's a variable underscore name. Okay, just like we give in mathematics, we use a square plus b square. Okay, so name is a variable underscore name is a variable. Okay, This is all variable, correct? Now variable equals input, okay, which has values of course the value which you are going to get input from the keyboard, input from the keyboard. All of you with me up to this point? So whatever is getting entered, whatever is getting entered will come here, okay? So now if I want to print this, so let's go and print, say hello, print. Now I'm saying hello to myself, or what, hello to this variable. So hello comma, and whatever you gave will be assigned here, printed. That's a variable name. How hard is that? How hard is it? Let's run this code and try to understand what Python does. Okay, so what I'm doing, print hello world, variable name, input, enter your name. Okay, so it will ask here, then you provide your name, that value will be assigned to this guy, okay, and then we print that particular value. I'll give you a chart of this, don't worry. Okay, so let's run this. So run, so it asks here your name. Okay, I'm entering my name, Rishi, and enter. It says hello Rishi. Isn't that awesome? It says hello Rishi. Now I'll explain you what exactly happened behind the scene. It's very simple algorithm. I'll show you. Let me start my journal. Okay, questions? Questions up to this point? Okay, what happened here? We say variable underscore name. This is what? What happens here is we are giving a name to a memory location, like you have a name, correct? Now you say input means whatever getting provided by Python, by the keyboard input, and some message here, correct? So now when you provide, when you ask for this message, let's say your name, okay, and you are providing Rishi, you are providing your name, you are not providing Rishi. What happens, this particular value will be assigned to this particular variable, okay? And what happens, you will get a memory map like this. Variable underscore name and the value is Rishi. This happens internally. Computer stores this for you. So next time when you use this particular variable, the value of that will be automatically taken. We have done this, right? We have done this for mathematics a lot, all right? So this is like we calculated, this is side A, this is side B, we said X, and X square equals 2, A square plus B square. All these things, A, B, X are what? These are variables, right? Agree? All of you with me? You're getting it? Same thing we are doing here. We are taking some variables and we're assigning some values. Got it? Good with this? So now you are literally taking, but where did we assign the name? Okay, good one. So we assign the name here in input function. Okay, we are assigning in input function. So input is a function which is taking the value from keyboard. Okay, so let's come back here and let's execute it again. So variable name equals to input, enter your name. So whatever value will be entered here will be assigned here in variable. Got it? It is very similar to this. Let me tell you this calibration. Okay, now I'm directly assigning here and the rest of this. Oops. Hello Rishi, but I don't want to hard code this. Okay, I'm taking the value from keyboard. I'm making the stuff complicated for you. This is very complicated code. I'm just testing whether you are able to understand and making sure that Python is easy. Okay, so now take it from keyboard, input, ask to the user who is using this program, enter your name. Okay. And then whatever value you give here, whatever value you give here will be assigned to this variable name. Do you want to try that now? Hello, now see this. Hello world, enter your name. It's asking and its cursor is waiting for my input. Okay, now give your name, Rishi, and enter. So you will get hello variable name, hello Rishi. Did you get this code? This is very complicated. I'm really like, if you understand this, you're actually understanding a lot of cool stuff. Are you all with me up to this point? How many yes I can get? Did you understand the code? Now, can you do that on your prompt, onlinepython.com? Can you do that on your prompt and check? View your name and say hello to yourself. All of you. If you can do this, then there is nothing more complicated, I promise. Because this is something which is using functions. This has a lot of things. This has variables, this has function calls, all those things. Okay. Awesome. I get 1, 2, 3, 4, 11. 13, 11. Okay. We have 29, 30 people, 11 people are trying. That's it. No, everybody. Yes, that's good. Yes, excellent. Okay, please try that yourself, because unless and until you do that, you will not get the feel of it. You will not understand the power of it. It's very important, because I tell you, I promise you, if you, and okay, let's do one thing. Search this. Take input from keyboard in Java. I'm not against Java. I started my career with it. Okay, it's a mother tongue. But reading input from keyboard in Java, just compare. Okay, just a comparison in front of you for doing what? This is the code. Understand this? This is the code. It's taking three values. Okay. How complicated is that? Got it? How complicated is that? That's very simple code right here. And this is the code for entering some name. Okay. Entering some values. Okay. Okay, so what was the question? Hold on, there is a question here. Let me answer that question quickly. Hello world variable name equals to input, enter your name, and hello variable name. And but I get this hi PyCharm. This is surprising. I don't have an idea. Hi PyCharm. Where is this hi PyCharm is coming? I'm on PyCharm. Okay, so now as of now, let's go through this one only. Okay, don't try anything in PyCharm as of now. We'll be using PyCharm, okay, for Python learning, definitely. Okay, we will explore that later. As of now, let's continue here. Try to understand what exactly is going on in this particular stuff. Let's introduce ourselves to Python first. Will with this? We'll solve that issue, Shweta. Don't worry. Okay. In Java, it's long code using scanner. Yes. Okay. So let's come back to the PPT and let's understand what exactly you did. Use the print function. What are the things you did up to this point? You know what you learned? Somebody raise the hand. Please type the question directly. Don't worry. You can write the question directly. What are the things you learned? Let's come back. I'm just opening your question. Don't worry. Making sure that we understand everything. So questions are open with me. Now, what are the things you learned today? Okay, up to this point, you learned about print function. You learned about input function. But what is function, by the way? How to use print and input data and print it? how to use print and input data and print it. That's what we did. Neha, I didn't understand your question. Can you please explain? Function, certain piece of code which is reusable. Amazing. That's exactly right. How many of you use toaster today? Toaster. Everybody has a toaster, seen toaster? What exactly happens? You provide input to it, you provide bread to it, right? And what you get out of it is a toast. Correct? And then toaster has an inner logic. It has a timer, it has electrical component, it has heat component, okay? And it has spring component to pop up your bread and all those things. And what? All these things are applied on an input. Input is provided to you. Input is provided to toaster, which is bread. Correct? And you ultimately get a processed output. Correct? Processed output, that is toaster. And whenever you apply that principle to a programming language, whenever you think about a toaster in a programming language, like you provide an input and you get processed output. That process which is doing that stuff is called as what? Function. Function is a reusable code. You can reuse for all the inputs. So the Python provided lot of functions, I promise. Lot of functions. One of that function is print. So you use that print function here. You use that print here and pass the input so that you get processed. What is the process output here? The process output is printing that value, printing that a string, printing that assigned value in console. That is the function of print. Input. Input is a function. Whenever you provide an input to it, it's the cursor. It takes the value from the keyboard. So there are a lot of functions like that which will help us. Because if you think about it, if programming language give everything to us and we have to code everything from scratch, then we are still on the stone age, correct? Everything written in binary format, zeros and one, correct? That's not required anymore because lot of functions are available and function makes our life easy. Did you get that? Are you all with me? So all the things in front of you now, like your mute button, okay, your screen button, your chat boxes, all those things are reusable. What? Functions. Clear to you, all of you? So understood what is function? Now I just want to add, let's go to the slides again. Okay. So Python syntax. So what is syntax, by the way? See, when you speak English, when you write English, you have certain syntaxes, right? You use semicolon somewhere. Okay. You use colon somewhere. You use period for just closing your statement. What does Python? Yes, grammar. Absolutely. What does Python use? Python is a language, right? There is a lot of programming language. Programming languages also have grammar. That's correct, Shweta. That's a grammar. So what is grammar for Python? So let's try to understand, like, how to end the statement in Python. Do we do any special thing here for ending a statement? No. So for Python, ending statement is nothing. Okay. So Python ends its statement with new line character. Okay, you don't have to do anything, just enter. Okay, so new line character, that means the character is basically don't have to give any period, no semicolons, nothing. Okay, that's the Python. So Python ends its statement with new line character. You don't have to give any ending line. Lot of programming language uses a semicolon, okay, or colon. Lot of programming like that. Will you do this? How to write a comment? What is comment? Comment is something like this. This is like a developer's way to explain the code. Developer's way to explain the code. Remember that whenever you write a program, you know what program does. But that particular program will be maintained by somebody else. Probably after 6 months or 8 months after you did that. Okay, so you need to explain what you're doing. So suppose I want to explain here what's going on. What I will do, I will use hash symbol. So hash is used for developers or programmers comment. what does comment really mean? So comment means Python compiler does not interpret this statement. I used two important word here. Python compiler does not translate, let's say, translate this statement. Python compiler does not start. It actually doesn't care. This is not Python anymore. So if you want to add something which is not Python in Python program, you use comment. And these comments are additional help provided to you, provided to a person who is reading the code. Okay. Just make sure that he understands what you are writing. Okay. That is a comment. And how do you provide a comment? With the help of hash. With the help of hash. Okay. You can write English within Python with the help of hash. And that will be completely ignored by Python compiler. How to comment two lines of code together? Yes, two or three lines. Good one. Good question. So here I can only write one line, right? So that is bad. I might actually have to write multiple lines or explanation of this particular code. So how can I explain this code just in one line? That's a bad idea. So you can actually, so this one, the hash is also called as single line comment. But can I add a multi-line comment? Yes. So there are three single quotes you have to give. 1, 2, 3. Okay. And again, close this 1, 2, 3. Within that, whatever you write. So this is multi-line comment. And now you can explain your entire code. With that. So this is multi-line comment. So this is single line comment hash and multi-line comment with three single quotes. Are you all with me? Do you understand the importance of this? All of you with me up to this point? Now I have used a very particular word called as compiler. How many of you know what is compiler? What does compiler do? Anybody know that? Today, I'm going to give you a very weird kind of a concept. If you don't know already, a weird concept. Do you know that your program, your computer do not understand any of whatever you wrote? It doesn't understand that. Do you know that? Remember that computer is a machine, correct? It interprets and runs the code. Yes, absolutely. It interprets. It converts. But do you know what exactly it converts to? What exactly it converts to? Think about it. Binary, correct? Binary is what? Zeros and one, correct? All the people know that. Okay, let me explain you what exactly happens. See, the programming languages like this. Now, please focus here. This is very important, and this is the concept generic and forever. If you want to stand in IT industry, if you understand what is machine, everything is smooth and easy for you. Remember this, programming languages like this, like Python, Java, okay, or Go, Ruby, Java, whatever language you are, doesn't matter. These all languages are called as high level languages. Okay, high level languages needs certain kind of compilation. Compilation is what? Somebody has to understand this, what they are talking about, correct? So this compilation process, it converts your program into what? Zeros and one? No, they are not converting. This is the difference. This is the difference between normal understanding and deeper understanding. Compiler converts your code into an operating system level code. Operating system has to understand this, not your computer. Your computer is not interacting with you. Please remember that. Your operating system is understanding. Your operating system is actually helping you. That's why when you downloaded Python, I told you to choose your operating system, correct? Because the compiler which you are downloading is based on your OS. Is this clear? Is this clear up to this point? You are not interacting with computer. Now, operating system is basically written in certain low level languages, okay, which interacts with hardware. So this is a hardware language, okay, and now it's operating system's responsibility to convert what you ask for. If you ask for printing something, operating system takes that to the hardware and make sure that it actually gets executed, you get desired output, and that output is passed on to the compiler's output. Good with that, this thing happens. But this does this low level language is zeros and one? No, it's not. Even the low level language needs a compilation. Now we are going way deeper. You have to be with me here. Okay, way deeper. This hardware language, okay, goes beyond this, okay, to convert something as zeros and one. Okay, these are drivers, these are assemblers. Okay, assemblers, drivers, all these things are doing what? They are understanding the code in zeros and one. Pull with that. What is zeros and one? If we can teach what is zero and what is one to the computer, there have been 40 to 50 years computer were existing. Why can't we teach two to them, three to them, four to them, five to them? Why zeros and one? Remember that. Again, we are going way deeper. Machine. It's a machine. It doesn't understand zeros and one also. Please remember that machine doesn't understand any zero. Anyone, this is something your interpretation of voltage levels. Do you know this? Because it's machine, right? It understands only codes. Okay, so people coming from electrical electronic background, they understand this. Now everything in the computer is nothing but this particular cycle. This is your machine cycle. Why I'm telling you all this thing in detail? Making sure that you know the stuff from the depth. Okay, so now machine understand this one is a voltage level, and what machine does is, this is, let's say, 2.5 volt line. Anything below 2.5 volt considered as zero, anything 2.5 volt above it's considered as one. Now teach him two. Is it possible to understand what is two? It's not possible. That's why up to this point machine always understood zeros and one. It's not even zeros and one. It's only what? It's just a voltage levels. So machine understand voltage levels. Okay, below certain voltage is zero, above certain voltage is one. Up to that point, okay, and then there are circuits, there are drives where it can store the state. Okay, what is all those things? So basically, all these things happens behind the scene whenever you program something. Okay, and your CPU, central processing unit, is capable of converting this, storing this. Okay, and let's not go beyond that. That will be a computer engineering very detail. So I heard the term third level and fourth level languages. What does that really mean? No. That's not level, that's generation. Okay, so voltages are human interpretation as a binary. No, voltage are machine interpretation of binary. Zeros and one are human interpretation of binary, right? Getting my point? Good with this. Okay, so now when you are doing this, when you are using Python, what's happening behind the scene? So Python, there is something called compiler. Now what you actually downloaded today is this guy, Python compiler, and this compiler, on the basis of Python language on it, okay, creates a complete package, and package plus compiler. Okay, depending on operating system, and then you are using it. With this, why this is important? When you go to the concepts like cloud and all, you need to understand this concept very well, because in cloud there are a lot of infrastructure part. You will actually create your own OS and all. So if you know this stuff in that detail, you will grasp the concept much faster. With this, all this, whatever I said, is this clear? Is this clear? I need, even if there is one no, okay, I'll explain, but it's very important for you to understand this. Cool with me, all of you with me? I think this is done, so let's close this. Okay, amazing, amazing, amazing. So now you are getting deeper and deeper. It is getting exciting, right? It's a very exciting journey. So let's go to the next one. Next slide. Use variables. So what happens to the variables? In this particular journey, where are the variables standing? So what happens? Remember that again. Whatever you do with the operating system also interacts with. So your compiler talking to OS. OS talking to two important entities. One is your memory. Another is CPU. Okay. So whenever you create a variable, whenever you say that I want to store a value, what your OS or what your compiler does is, let's assume compiler only. Okay. Let's keep the layer of OS as of now, just for speaking purpose. So what compiler does is, compiler creates a memory location. And how do you identify that memory location? So suppose you got a dog. Okay, tomorrow you get a dog. The first thing you do is what? Assign a name to him, right? Assign name to it, right? That's what you're gonna do. So you got a memory location, you want to identify later. So you provide a name to it, that's called as variable name. You name that variable something. Okay. So suppose I'm saying it's called as EMP ID, employee ID. And now when you assign the value to that variable, that value goes here. 1011. So next time when you call employee ID, please come here. What will come? 101. This is just a name, right? The actual value is this. So this will actually return. Got it? So variable is nothing but a memory location with name and the value. Cool with this? It has one more component to it, but today we don't understand that. Cool with that? How to understand, define a compiler? Compiler is your high level programming language converted into operating system programming language. That's it. That is called as compiler. Okay, compiler compiles. It's just like, you know, so Anshul, you are, let's say you are a Telugu person and I am a Marathi person. Okay, so now we have to speak with each other. So somebody has to stand in between to convert that language, right? All of both of us. That is compiler. That's it. It's a translator between you and me. Getting my point? Because he is not actually going to speak in your language, and you're not going to speak in that language. Correct? Awesome. So now come back here. Add numbers, print variables, string variables. We are going to do this. Okay, we are doing some programming, awesome stuff. Okay, so let's take a practical problem now. Okay, shall I eliminate this code? Do you want this code? I'll just copy this and put it in the slide, and I can share this slide with you. Oh, this is bad. I think I can eliminate this. A better version of this. And some spelling mistake, please ignore my spelling mistakes. I'm really bad in this. I'm pretty dependent on these things. Automated. I'll share this thing with you and make sure that I'm getting a smaller font of this so that it looks like a code at least. Okay, so you can copy paste that, of course. This is a multi-line code. Awesome. Right, so next, go to the next one. So now we're going to talk about variables. Now my problem is, can I add two numbers? Let's say the program for that. So I'm just eliminating that. Or you can add a new tab, not a problem. And here I'm gonna take two important variables and add them. Okay. So I'm just saying variable underscore one equals value is 100. Or you can take an input, that is up to you. Variable underscore two. These are the values. And I'm gonna add them. Okay, so I'm just say total equals to variable one plus variable two and print total. Total. How many of you understood the code? Is it hard? Taking two values, variable one, variable two. Okay, assign the values 100, 200. So what exactly happened at this point? What happened here? So at this point, this particular thing is went to the memory location, correct? And now you stored variable 1 and stored the value as 100. Next time this guy, this is another memory location, key value pair again, he is variable 2 and assign the value 200. And now you say total, total is another variable, so total. So total. And what happened at this point? What you said is variable 1 plus variable 2. You called out variable 1. Who will come? 100 will come there. So 100. Variable 2, who will come? 200 will come there. 100 plus 200, what will happen? It will actually do the calculation and save it here. So when you ask for total, print total, it's going to say total colon, call for that value, 300. Got it? That's the program for addition of two numbers. How hard is that? It is simpler than our eighth standard mathematics. So forget about eighth standard, second standard mathematics, correct? So now let's run this code. Let's see whether it's really working that way. So go ahead, run. And total is 300. Can you convert this to take the input from keyboard? You can do that. Think about it. Can you convert this to take an input from keyboard? How can you do that? Anybody? Yeah, I can share the code on chat box. Input function. So simple, right? Input, absolutely, Radhika. Great, Priya. Very nice. So let's do that. Say input. Okay. Or if you want, you can directly give input, or if you want to prompt the user, you can actually say variable 1. Correct. And give a cursor or colon. Oh, I'll delete this. Don't worry. It's disturbing. Okay. Yes. Cool. Then input. Say variable 2. You are already writing a very complicated code. Okay. And now let's see the total. Let's see the code. Let's see. Variable 1, 100. Variable 2, 300. Enter. Oh, what happened? What happened? It says 100, 300. What's the problem? It has taken this thing as a string. Okay. So I cannot explain that. Okay. It's concatenated. Exactly. That is the word. Okay. It's called a string concatenation. It's converted the input into string. It is not ideally behaving like an integer. So what's the solution of that? We're going to convert that into integer, but as of now, we'll not do it. Okay. It will be very complicated for that. Okay, yes, you can use int function for that. Okay, people know it, but that's amazing. But as of now, we'll not use it because everybody else will get confused. Okay, so what you have to go with, so whenever you are getting these variables, they are strings. That means they are considered as a strings, just like a name, just like your employee's name, customer's name, all those things, right? Similar to that, it taken that as string. Okay, set of characters, set of alphabets, correct? Awesome. So now this is the code for that. Pull with this. Now, how hard it is to actually, so let's see this. Let's see the next slide. How hard it is to read the file in Python? Can I read a file in Python? Okay. Is it really complicated code? So can I read a file in Python? How hard it is and what is the open function? So that's what we're going to do. But for that, we need to actually open our PyCharm, because if I have to read the file on my computer, or my browser will not support that. Correct? My browser is not a good option for that. Hold with this. So I might have to open my own IDE. Actually, we are lack of time. We are already passed on this time. So let's take this particular program tomorrow. But is it something which I have to answer today? So let's take this particular program tomorrow. I'll actually explain this, and we'll also take an introduction to cloud. I'll give you three important definition. Okay. How cloud computing is used, what is private cloud, what is public cloud, and where exactly Python resides in this particular thing, in this particular journey. Cool with this? Are you all with me up to this point? Okay, so let me do one thing. I will add this particular code which are wrote here, input and output, input and providing an output with variables. You know how many definitions you have learned today? Just revise the quick. We went here, we understood functions. I told you the definition of function. Okay, we understand what is variable. We understood two important functions today, hello function and input function. Okay, we understand what is compiler, what it actually works on. We also understand comments, single line and multi line comment, what it is used for in actual scenario. Okay, we understand variables and how variables are assigned memories. Okay, and we created two important codes, addition, simple addition, and simple input taking from the keyboard. Such a big journey we have taken today. Is it overwhelming? Is it huge? Can you please explain about return command? Return is not a command, it's a statement. Okay, there is difference between command and statement. Okay, return returns the value. So when you write a function, Neha, when you write a function, the function returns something value. Just like when you again, I gave an example of toaster, right? You provided bread to a toaster. What's the return value? What it comes back? A toast. That is a return. Return is an output of a function. Okay. Awesome. It's not overwhelming, right? You are still able to learn. That's what the good thing about Python. It's very easy. It's very comfortable. It's something like English. How many of you agree? It's something like English. Are you all with me? Are you agree on that? It's very straightforward. It's very easy. It's not at all a programming. Think about it. Okay. So any question I have to answer for today, and we can close this and we can go tomorrow with what? Two important things. We can read a file. Send a video. Yes, absolutely. Everybody get a video. If you are not getting it, please drop me an email. Okay, because you assigned that, like whoever attended this particular, whoever registered for this particular session with the email ID will automatically get a video. We created a program like that. If you're not getting it, let us know. Okay, and I'm gonna write this code here. Quickly add that. And I'll share this with you. So you will get this code also today so that you can try it on editor. Okay, so this is code 2 and this is code 1. Cool. You did not get recording. Okay, so people who did not get recording, can you please drop me an email, because you should automatically get it. Okay, that's what the program is. So rishi.h2kinfosys@gmail.com, that's my email address. If you do not get it, okay, and you should actually send it to one more you know that is h2kinfosys@gmail.com. that is also training@h2kinfosys.com. that is also fine. Yeah, both of them are valid. All of them are valid, don't worry. Okay, so send it to me that you are not getting a video, and I'll definitely make sure that you get video as well as this PPT content. Cool. So let's tomorrow, what we're gonna do, open the file and literally read the file. It's not hard, I promise. And then you will be surprised to see how easy Python is. And then we will also understand important concepts about cloud. I will actually remove all the hurdles and all the fuzzy definitions of cloud, okay, from your mind. Okay, awesome. So let's stop here and let's continue tomorrow. Thanks a lot, everyone. It was a wonderful thing. It's enjoying, right? Are you all enjoying? Yes or no? Are you all enjoying? This is fun-based learning model. Fun-based learning model. You should enjoy this. Okay. Awesome. Awesome. So thanks a lot, everyone. Have a good one. Let's meet tomorrow. Okay. Bye-bye. Yeah. Thanks, Mala. Thank you, everyone. Bye.